Well, you know actress Elizabeth Rome best for her long-running role on Law and Order, but she kept her struggle with infertility private until now. Her new book is titled Baby Steps, Having the Child I Always Wanted, Just Not As I Expected. Good morning. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning to you.
So this is very interesting. Here you are. You're successful. You're beautiful. No one knows about this struggle with infertility. Right. Why write a book about this time where you were unsuccessful and it's not a pretty time?
You know, I started writing a blog for People.com about 2.5 years ago, and I went through this process of writing the blog that perpetuated the myth and then writing the blog that started to tell the truth. And moms and women, they want to hear it as it is. Mm-hmm. You know, they want straight talk. And as I started to write my blog from that point of view, I decided that there was a part of my life that I really hadn't been straight with other women about. And being an advocate for women, which is my number one priority other than, you know, my little woman, my daughter, mm-hmm. I decided to write about my fertility struggles because I just felt like I had never had those moments with women where they had been forthcoming with me and right. said, well, I have this beautiful child, but I did 5 rounds of IVF, and right. and so as I went through it, it was like I was side-blinded. I never expected at 34 to go and find out that I was never going to be able to have a child naturally. And the idea to be able to bring to light, you know, these statistics that women really actually are going to struggle with, perhaps. I mean, sometimes women get pregnant at 42, 46. Mm-hmm. Miracles happen every day. We're all very different. And for me, it happened early. I had accelerated ovarian aging, which was unusual for a 34-year-old.
What's interesting here is you talk about being a very private person going into this. And then, and in the end, you open up, you know, about all the feelings you had, a lot of feelings of inadequacy that you run through. How difficult was it doing that?
I think when you have a purpose, and maybe the purpose is to bring awareness to something, you can forget your fear of wanting, you know, to keep yourself private. I mm-hmm. do think there are things in life that are sacred, like your family, none other than your family. Mm-hmm. It's the most sacred part of your life. But mm-hmm. if you can serve other people, other women, by educating, and knowledge is power. I mean, I'd like women to know that the statistics get really scary once you reach 35, and even scarier once you reach 40, and that 70 to 80 million people suffer from fertility issues in the world, and that it's not something to be ashamed of. If men struggle with fertility, if women struggle with fertility, you're not less than, you know, someone else who doesn't. And to just right. speak about it openly, just to have a conversation, you know, I hope the book is a call to action. I hope it makes women think at 30, maybe once a year I'll go check my ovarian reserve and my hormone levels and leave it at that. You know, that's information.
Well, you know what? I think a lot of people are going to appreciate that book. Elizabeth Rome, thanks for joining us. Thank you.